The chief work of the Holy Spirit is to testify about Jesus, to give witness about Jesus. Any true child of God who is one with the Holy Spirit, he will talk about Jesus and nothing else. The more he gets one with the Holy Spirit, the more he talks about Jesus. The more he becomes one with the Holy Spirit, more self is gone. There is utter lowliness and nothingness of self. And there is allness of Jesus. Maybe ordinary housewife, maybe ordinary person, may not be a preacher, but there is so much of Jesus revealed through them. Why? Because they are one with the Holy Spirit. He that is joined to the Lord is one spirit with the Lord. In the light of this word, we will check our passion. What is our passion? You'll be surprised to know that many believers and even many Christian workers, preachers and pastors, don't know what to do and how to enter into the fullness of God. They have no idea about entering into the fullness of God, possessing the fullness of God, having God's fullness in them. They talk on many other subjects. They talk on the works of God, but they don't talk on the person of God. They don't talk about possessing God. They don't talk about being filled with God. Why? Because their eyes are on what they can do, what they can do for God. Their eyes are on the work of God, not on God Himself. And most of the prayer is, Lord, give me power, give me anointing, give me authority, give me gifts. Why? So that I want to do something. I want to go here. I want to go there. For going and for doing. But very few people's prayer is, God, I want the anointing to know you. I want to know you. Paul's passion was to know Jesus. Moses' desire, in spite of seeing mighty works, was, I want to know you. Show me your glory. No wonder we have to desire to work for God, to be used by God. But our first desire and foremost desire will be to know Jesus, to be filled with Jesus, so that we can have the fullness of Jesus and give Jesus to others in His fullness. Why many people pray, give me the anointing, give me power, give me gifts? So that deep in the heart it is, I will become great or greater. I will be used by God. But there is no passion or equal passion to know Jesus. I want to know Jesus and I want to make Jesus known to others. Miracles will happen, healings will happen, blessings will come because our God Himself is a blesser God, is a miracle worker. Jesus should be our passion. Knowing Jesus should be our passion. Making Jesus known to others should be our passion. Being conformed to the image of Jesus should be our passion. Making our church, our people conformed into Christ-likeness should be our passion. Jesus is our perfect example. Preach Jesus, teach Jesus, make people like Jesus, make your church like Jesus. We are the followers of Jesus Christ. Make people into His image, especially your young people. What are you teaching your young people? Your style? Your ways? Or you're teaching them to be like Jesus? The only hope for India's salvation is people like Jesus Christ. Not stylish preachers, stylish pastors, big crowd pullers. No! It is people like Jesus, simple, ordinary people, but whose life is like Jesus. In your working place, in your business, in your day-to-day life, you just live like Jesus and people see Jesus and they will turn to Jesus. They will come to Jesus.